Hi, my name is Mike. I'm a professor for social work management. And you are listening to Managing Around, the bi-weekly podcast about social science, culture, and management. Managing Around is part of the Talk About Organizations podcast network, a community resource and discussion platform for key ideas in management and organization studies, which is supported by our listeners.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to this new episode. The role of social work and human service organizations should not be underestimated. They fill a gap in a society that cannot be fulfilled by governments and people in their individual capacities. These organizations face many challenges and issues, as they provide essential services and potential support to people in need. For this very episode, the focus is put again on the type of leadership provided in social work organizations, because it then impacts the level of success experienced by the staff and other stakeholders. In recent years, more focus has been given to agile leadership and its potential positive impact on achieving the set goals and objectives it provides. This podcast will provide insights to agile leadership in social work organizations. We will start with what it is and we'll discuss later how it could change the work in these organizations. What I will present in the following is a short summary of the research I undertook in the last few days. Before we start, I'd like to mention you will find the references to the works and studies I'm going to mention in this podcast in the show notes. Okay then, let's get started. And we will start with a definition of what social work organizations are. Organizations that provide human and social services are diverse and many. According to Benjamin and colleagues from 2018, some of the most common services include professional and social support such as child welfare services, elderly and aging services, providing food to the poor and shelter to the homeless, guiding counseling services, among many others. Ultimately, through these organizations mostly provide volunteer work, their leadership needs to be formal and competent. With other words, also these organizations should be run as if they were any other enterprise. This, however, calls for agile leadership. What is agile leadership? It is important to understand leadership and then link it to these social work and human service organizations. Atter and Abdul Karim from 2020 point out that at its most basic and core sense, agile leadership refers to a leadership that is continuously changing and willing to adapt to change in situations and circumstances. This is because the environment, both the business and non-business, is uncertain. The leadership of any organization should always be prepared and agile. It enables some organizations to survive, whereas others can thrive. Let's come now to the main point of this podcast today: agile leadership in social work and human service organizations. Agile leadership is necessary for these organizations because it changes the way teamwork is pursued, how continuous learning and improvements would be possible, and how a commitment can be developed within your team. Okay, let's start with the first aspect, the relevance of teamwork. Teamwork is important for the achievement of social work services. According to Morrison and colleagues from 2019, agile leadership advocates for teamwork. In modern organizations, teamwork rather than individuality leads to the quicker and more successful achievement of the set goals and objectives. The social work and services provided by non-profit organizations are diverse. They include both office work and, more importantly, field work. At the field work level, where in many cases a huge number of people work in different places, agile leaders need to appreciate the importance of the team and to delegate the necessary roles and responsibilities to the team. Let's now move on to the next and second aspect of agile leadership in social work organizations, the continuous learning and improvement. In agile leadership, the leader should not rest on their laurels, but should instead strive for continuous learning and improvement. Such continuous learning in social work requires emotional intelligence and cultural competence. Betul from 2020 states that with emotional intelligence, a leader should understand their feelings and emotions, making them realize the available shortcomings and weaknesses. Cultural competence, in the contrary, is equally important because one understands and communicates properly with individuals from other cultures or those with a different perspective. Social work requires a huge team that is diverse in many ways. Leaders should understand themselves and look at things from the perspective of the social workers in the field. With such an approach, a leader will realize weaknesses and continuously learn. The social worker and volunteers in the field may be right, and the agile leader learns from them. Decisions will become more objective and do not contain too many biases. And thirdly, there is another aspect why agile leadership is so important: the commitment of the team. Agile leadership is necessary for institutions that provide physical and psychological engaging services, such as those that deal with the elderly or drug abusers. Breakspeare from 2017 argues that with agile leadership, the commitment and passion of workers will increase. This is mainly because they are consulted and make their contributions to the key decisions made. They feel accountable in them, and it increases their responsibility. In social work, these workers and volunteers have more commitment and persevere the challenges they face in the course of their work if the leader uses agile leadership. We are already at the end of this episode, and I will summarize some of the main conclusions. The mentioned research demonstrates that agile leadership is helpful in social work and human service organizations. It ensures that teamwork is used and the leader advocates for continuous learning and improvement. Despite the challenges faced by these workers and volunteers, agile leadership keeps their commitment and passion high. Last but not least, a complete rejection of agile approaches and methods may be difficult to enforce. Even skeptics tend to rate agile leaders positively, even if they express concern more often about possible side effects. Of course, further research is needed to better understand the theoretical foundations of the relationships between the various challenges, leadership behavior, and the agile practice.
Thank you for listening. Managing Around, the bi-weekly podcast about social science, culture, and management. Managing Around is part of the Talk About Organizations podcast network, a community resource and discussion platform for key ideas in management and organization studies, which is supported by our listeners. If you liked this episode, please leave a review on your favorite podcast website. There's also a link in the show notes. If you've got any thoughts on this episode, or
If you've got any idea about new podcast topics or questions you'd like to discuss, send me an audio file or voice note to hi@profmanagement.de. For any non-audio comments, drop a tweet or DM to @profmanagement on Twitter or Instagram, please. For more information, visit my website www.profmanagement.de. Thank you for listening and see you next time.